Morning, Brian Harris here for a operational briefing update on what's going on the fire, August complex on the northeast zone. So just real quick, an orientation of the map that we have here. This is the South Fork of the Trinity River, and that acts as the zone break between the northeast zone and the northwest zone. Way over here on our map, up in that direction off of our map, is Redding. Down here we have Pescanta down in here. Now Highway 36 comes through here. This is where the highway comes through, and of course that continues on to Fortuna out here. Mad River is located right in here. Hay Fork up here, Post Mountain, Wildwood, Begum. So that's kind of an orientation of where things are on this map. It's a large fire we have here, so it covers a big area, so we kind of need to get up to speed on where all this stuff is. Let's talk about our weather real quick. And again, this is our update for Saturday, October 10th. Let's talk about the numbers of acreage that have burned on this fire. So overall, the entire August complex has burned 1,024,092 acres. Now overall, including the south part of the fire, it's at 67% contained. When we talk just about our northeast zone of the fire, it's at 269,385 acres, and we have approximately 1,300 individuals that are assigned to this part of the fire. We do also have the Marines that are here to assist us, and they add a great capacity to us to work. They're located, camped out in another area down here as well, as well, one of our base camps is located at. For weather today, there's a chance of rain today, but not much rain. So unfortunately, this isn't going to be a season-ending event. We have about 70% cloud cover out there, and of course, when it's raining, we'll have essentially 100% cloud cover over parts of our fire. The most part of the rain that we're going to get right here is in the Progeny area, but still less than a tenth of an inch of rain. So not enough rain to actually turn the tides as far as the season-ending event. Down here in the rest part of the fire, you know, a couple 1/100ths of an inch, so not very much rain there as well. So at this time, I'd like to bring in Britt, our Deputy Operations Chief, for an update on what's going on in the fire.
Thanks. So kind of three main hotspots that we're dealing with on the fire. The first one's over here in Division India. Yesterday, fire came up at our primary line pretty hard, and spotted over the line in a couple places, but we had a lot of resources available to pick those spots up. They mopped that up through the night, and now it's pretty secure, and we're feeling pretty good about where we're at starting the day. Today, we're really just holding on. I'm going to be doing more check line. There was actually a question yesterday about what check line is, and a great example is we've got a dozer line here, and it just helps slow the fire down so that it doesn't get ahead of where we're ready to actually take action. And that's going to continue today. Again, it's winds focused. We've got pretty high winds for the next 2 days, so it's not conducive to burning. We're just holding on until things quiet down a little bit, and then we can keep going down our primary line. The second piece that's still kind of a busy spot for us is just to the south of Highway 36. A lot of folks in there heavily engaged. It's a mid-slope road, so a lot of fire gets down over our line, and we've got to go chase it. Just to keep that piece in check, really focusing on keeping fire out of Post Mountain. The third piece we're working on is down here on Division Mike. This finger is now, you know, about 85% lined. It's lined all up on the north piece. They've got pretty good odds of finishing lining down to this drop point 130 by the end of shift today, if not certainly by tomorrow. And then the last piece of the puzzle is tying it down into this buck fire. The buck fire has been a really good fire slowing feature, but right now we've got to figure out if we can tie it down into the Trinity Creek to really shut it down and call that good. So that's kind of a synopsis for what's going on today.
Britt, let me ask you just a couple of questions real quick. When we look at this map, we see a lot of red and we see a lot of black too. So just for reference, all this black that you see through here is really dozer line that's out there, and that's a containment line for us. You know, the red is showing the hot line of where the fire is currently located at. So what does it take, Britt, to kind of make this red line once we've worked it? What type of standards are we looking for before we'll take that piece of line right here and call that contained?
So the big thing that turns this red line into one of these black lines is it's got to be mopped up. And mop up is, you know, it's really situational depending on the fuels, the topography. It could be anywhere from 50 feet in to 300 feet in. But really what it is once it's been mopped up to whatever you need at that point, you're saying that fire is not going to come over this line anymore. So we can say that down here. Up here, we can't say that yet. We're still mopping up and securing it, and it's not to the point where we can definitively say it's done moving. Expect once the winds pass, you're going to start seeing a lot more black show up on this stretch of line, you know, the next 2 to 4 days.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Red. So that's our morning update for today. If you need additional information, a great place to find information is on InsaWeb. Also on the right-hand side of InsaWeb page, you'll find our phone numbers right there too. So please don't hesitate to give us a call, and we'd be glad to share more information with you.